In this example, we are given that two particles of masses m1 and m2 are initially at rest at infinite separation. M1 released, find the relative velocity of approach when they are at a separation d. Now, in this problem, we are given that initially the particles are at infinite separation, so we can write initial energy of system can directly be written as E initial is equals to 0. And when we release the particles due to their mutual gravitational attraction, these are attracted towards each other. And when they are at a separation d, say situation is this, when the two masses are at separation d, say m1 is moving at a speed v1 and m2 is moving at a speed v2, then we can simply state at separation d, the total energy of system is this E final, it can be written as minus gm1 m2 by d, that's the gravitational interaction energy of these two particles, plus their kinetic energy, half m1 v1 square plus half m2 v2 square. Now, in this situation, by energy conservation, initial and final energy has to be equal. So, we can directly write in the situation that minus gm1 m2 by d plus half m1 v1 square plus half m2 v2 square, this should be equal to 0. As initial energy when they're at infinite separation was 0. And along with this, we also have, as no external forces acting on system here, we can write as F external on system is 0. This implies system momentum will remain conserved, and we can write M1 V1 is equals to M2 V2. So when they are at infinite separation and it is given that initially these particles were at rest, so initial momentum of system was 0. So at this stage, the momentum will be, this would be m1 v1 minus m2 v2, that should also be 0. So from here we can substitute the value of v2 here. So we'll get half m1 v1 square plus half m2, and v2 we can substitute from here as m1 v1 by m2 square is equals to, we can take this term on right hand side, it is gm1 m2 by d. And on simplifying this expression, we can take this V common out. On solving, we can say, on solving for V1, we get the value of V1 as root of twice G by D M1 plus M2 multiplied by M2. Similarly, when we substitute this V1 here, we'll get the value of V2, which is root of 2g by dm1 plus m2 multiplied by m1. And if these are the velocities of m1 and m2 when they are approaching each other, so we can write their approach velocity should be v1 plus v2. If we substitute the values of v1, v2 here, the result of approach velocity in this expression will be the root of twice g m1 plus m2 by d. That will be the answer to this problem.